بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. السلام عليكم. I am honored to speak before this group of scholars, and I am also honored to speak in a seminar with Dr. Hassa, Dr. Tidi, and Dr. Amer Saadi. Okay. My presentation or my speech for today is about the challenges and opportunities that we are at Qatar University are facing at this time of our era. Directly, I will move towards the my speech. Qatar University was established in 1974 as a college with four different academic departments. In 1977, this college has been transferred into a university. Currently, we have seven colleges: arts and sciences, education, sharia, engineering, business, law, and pharmacy. We have more than 600 faculty members. We provide at the university more than 64 academic programs. Currently, maybe 10% of these programs are for master degrees. We have also about 9,000 students. Three out of four of them are female students. In 2003, the university went through a major reform. This reform project gave the university its independence. We went through a major hierarchy, new structure for our organization, and we also currently, or let's say 2 or 3 years ago, have so many challenges. These challenges included when you look at research from research perspective, includes poor institutional infrastructure. Most of our research laboratories are for teaching purpose. Our faculty were mainly engaged in teaching of their time. We have limited and scale and very small critical mass of faculty who can conduct research in specific areas. We also have less resources for research. Academic workload is very high for our faculty members to conduct research. For our new disciplines also, we do not have research tradition, and also limited interdisciplinary integration between different colleges, departments, and disciplines. And also, it is difficult to manage the growth of the importance of research. Since the establishment of QNRF, QSTP, this has put a lot of pressure on us to how to handle and administer research grants. The government, the state of Qatar, had initiated the Vision 2030. This vision also, which also addresses the knowledge-based economy, or to reach knowledge-based economy by the year 2030, put another pressure at the university. Since we are the national university, we have to be dynamic, and we have to play a major role in achieving this vision by the year 2030. So we had to readapt and modify our vision and mission. In doing so, there were three major options available for us: whether to stay as a teaching university to provide the government or the different industrial sectors with the skilled laborers, or to become teaching and research and research engagement, or to become a sole research university. Of course, since the establishment of, or the adaptation of, this new vision, we cannot stay as a teaching university. This is not a wise approach for us, or a strategy, neither becoming a research university. where maybe two-thirds of our students are engaged in research. So we have adapted to become a teaching and research university, where we envision that in 10 years of time, probably one-third of our students will be engaged in real research, and our faculty contribution for research and outcomes will be more than two papers per faculty per year. So in order to set our strategic planning priority and priorities, we have to shape or we have to do or to work on what we should do, not simply of what can or are best equipped to do. This is in order to readjust our activities to what are the aspiration of our society is. Optimal use of scarce resources in both human resources, physical resources, and financial resources. Align institutional competencies with external environment and national aspirations. Balance existing capability with potential and local or regional opportunities, and interdisciplinary integration for synergy. With respect to our objectives, we have set major objectives for us to grow research capability and capacity. We need to build our research capacity at the university level to ensure a strong research teaching nexus, strengthen industry community outreach and engagement to address national priorities, to link research to wider societal responsibilities, to increase and allocate resources to facilitate productivity and reward excellence, to establish research clusters, centers for excellence, and to enhance institutional status and branding. We need to work in more than one front. The first thing is to build our organizational capacity for research. We need to restructure our current organization to introduce new policies and procedures, as well as new systems for the university, so that we set out the soft infrastructure for research environment. As well as we need to build our human capacity for research through adapting new HR policies, training our faculty and researchers, and introducing reward and awarding schemes. We also need to establish and support research centers for excellence through engaging our faculty through multidisciplinary and interdisciplinary to build research clusters and teams and what have you, and to develop a strategic research partnership locally and internationally. In building the capacity and our competency, it is through recruiting faculty and researchers, reinvigorate our current researchers and faculty member, training, reorient some of our activities and research of interest, enabling our faculty, as well as rewarding and retaining the best faculty and researchers. We also try to introduce some incentives and rewards through providing more time for research for our faculty who would like to engage in research through targeted grants internally or external grants, enhancing our current facilities, laboratories, internships with industry or other partners, salary increases, sabbatical leaves, award of excellence, and what have you. In setting our research priorities, we also thought of which approach we should follow. Is it through centralization or top-down approach, or bottom up or combination. We decided to go through the latest one of them. In identifying our priorities, we also thought of whether to work or to concentrate in applied research, industry related activities or fundamental research. It's also through institutional significance. What is the significance for this priority for our university? The collaboration that we can engage our faculty in the interdisciplinary, regional or local significance, a new or emerging domain, creative practice and engagement with our stakeholders. So our basic or let's say initial research priorities that we have came up with, and this is still not final, it is undergoing study, in areas of health, ICT, environment, energy, materials and social and social sciences and humanities. So these are the areas, most of them are in areas that has been recognized by QNRF and Qatar Foundation. Currently we have several research centers, environmental study center, material technology unit, gas processing center. We have also established Qatar University Wireless Innovation Center at QCP in partnership with the Qatar Science and Technology Park. We have an opinion poll center, and there are some others in the pool related to computer and computer science and engineering, as well as in biomedical facilities. We are enjoying several funding opportunities through either Qatar National Research Fund, Qatar Science and Technology Park, local institutions, as well as international funding agencies. For example, with respect to the NPRP funding scheme, which is the national flag program by Qatar National Research Fund, through the last cycles, our grants increased from around $6 million to $54 million in just 3 years. Most of these funding projects were in the area of engineering and technology, as well as in natural sciences. With QCP, we established Qatar Science and Technology Park. At Qatar Science and Technology Park, we established Qatar University Wireless Innovation Center, QUIC. Why at QCP? Because we believe that this center could quickly produce or move from applied research towards development and commercialization. We also enjoy several funding projects by QCP. I think Dr. Tidu mentioned some of these projects. We also need to, because I stated that all of these funding requires management and proper administration, so we established our Office of Research, Office for Academics. This is a one shop or one stop shop that, provides financial and budget advice for our researchers, identify funding opportunities, project preparation, research project administration, training and mentoring, as well as in a later phase for intellectual property and commercialization. Some final thoughts, sustaining academic and professional reputation in knowledge-based economy is essential. Align academic activities with the economic development of Qatar. Retain and improve position, build on success. And this led us to work on some low-hanging fruits. It is essential that we motivate and to provide, to show that to show our administration and as well as our researchers that it is possible to conduct such research and it's possible to come up with tangible results. Attract and retain high quality faculty and students, maintain cutting edge curricula, and create a stimulating learning environment, and finally develop PhD research programs for tangible research. And we are soon going to announce a PhD program in the very near future at Qatar University. As it has been saying that may you live in a good time, ladies and gentlemen, I think here in Qatar, if you are living in Qatar, then you are living in a very good time. Thank you very much.